Dontae, I just want to say thank you so much for inviting me to do this challenge. I admire what you're doing for our reseller community, bringing us all together and giving back. I respect that so much about you, and I want to thank you again for inviting me, even though I failed. Hey you guys, what's up? My name is Brittany. If you are new to my channel, I am a part-time clothing and shoe, primarily, reseller on eBay, Poshmark, and Mercari. And in today's video, I'm gonna talk about my experience doing the Prison2Profit challenge. So my friend Dontae, he's also here on YouTube, he decided to do this challenge. You had 10 minutes to go to one Goodwill and spend $10 and kind of see what you could find. His goal with this was just to show that you can find money anywhere that you go. And I am honored that he invited me to do it. So thank you so much, Dontae. I really appreciate it. And I admire what you're doing for our community, bringing us all together, giving back. It speaks volumes, and I really appreciate it. And with that said, let me go ahead and talk about my experience. I happily accepted this challenge. However, it was harder than what I thought. 10 minutes is hard for clothing and shoes. Maybe it's not. People will probably disagree with this. Maybe it is for me because reselling is kind of an outlet. Like, it's like guilt-free shopping for me. I get to shop for other people. So I've realized that I like to take my time. So I filmed it. So I'll put it up while I'm talking about it. But my strategy was, I went on a Monday, and here in the local Houston area, like all the Goodwills around here, on Mondays is like the equivalent to the dollar day that some people have. We have 75% off of the color tag for the week. So this past Monday is when I went. It was green tag, and so if I found anything with green tag, it would be 75% off. So I'm like, this is perfect. This will be great for the challenge. And my game plan was to go to the jeans, because jeans can turn a really big profit for me. I can usually make anywhere from like 15 to 20 bucks per pair, depending on the brand, the style, the condition. I went to the jeans, and they were thoroughly picked over. I was a little disheartened. Like, I was watching the camera and the time was just ticking, and I'm like, ah, this isn't enough. I wanted to get like 5 pairs because they would have been $1.75 each. And that would be lovely for this challenge. I thought I would do really well, but I was having a hard time finding them initially. And with clothing, the way that I like to source, at least, I thoroughly look through everything, and 10 minutes goes fast. So I did find items in my first 10 minutes. However, I was a little disheartened with what I found. So I stayed in the Goodwill for quite a while. I was in there for honestly about an hour, but I am gonna show you what I found in my first 10 minutes, and it was less than $10. I actually have two things that just kind of doesn't line up. So here, I'll explain it. So in my first 10 minutes, I'll throw up the video. I found 2 pairs of jeans. I found these Hollister skinny jeans, just a women's size 3S, but they also have it in, the good thing about Hollister is they have it in like the normal men's sizing, 26 by 30, but it was the green tag, which I was excited, it means $1.75. They were just a good pair of skinny jeans for women. I know that I'll be able to probably start these at $20 to $25, so I would be able to make a $15 to $20 profit on them. So that was a good pickup, $1.75 for these. Anyways, I found those first, and then I found another pair of American Eagle jeans. I think these were the ones, because they were in the similar section. This is for the size, by the way. I thought it was the number, but it wasn't. And then I just found another pair of American Eagle women's jeans. Just some, let's see, just some high-rise jeggings, which do really well for me. The high-rise usually churn more money, so I'll probably list these at $30 to $35, and I expect probably about a $20 profit on them. So yeah, so we'll just say about, even if on the low end, $15 profit each. So turning $3.50 into about $30. This I did find in less than 10 minutes. I have it on video, so I have proof of it. So I'll submit this as a part of my challenge. Hopefully you don't disqualify me, Dontae. Don't disqualify me. It's okay. That's fine. It was a fun challenge. And the high-rise jeggings, Hollister skinny jeans, about 30 bucks I'm looking at right here. That is what I'm going to enter into this competition. And I do have my receipt as proof. But like I said earlier, I kind of spent longer than 10 minutes. I'm sorry, I failed. I should have gotten out of there, but can anybody relate to that? It was hard. It was hard to spend 10 minutes. So it was a really good challenge, and I appreciate you trying to challenge me, but I failed miserably. Thank you, Dontae, for doing this. Very inspiring to think about how far that money could take you. That's all I have for you guys today. Thank you so much for watching. Another big shout out to Dontae over at Prison2Profit. If you guys haven't subscribed to him already, please do. He's awesome. He is a ball of energy. I love his personality and his grind is there. Like, he is hustling hard. Thank you, Dontae. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure you hit the like button on the way out and I will catch you in my next video. Bye.